With WKUF News, I'm David Jackson for Friday, April 22nd, 2016. The state of Michigan is paying the attorney fees of the two men charged yesterday in connection with causing the Flint water crisis. Emily Lawler on MLive.com reports that civil service rules say that an employee named in a civil claim can request to be represented at the state's expense. The rule also states that providing legal defense is not required when a criminal suit is involved. According to Governor Snyder, the two DEQ employees are having their defenses paid for right now due to an ongoing investigation by the Michigan State Police, and future defense costs would likely be reconsidered. Governor Snyder sent a letter to State of Michigan employees yesterday in an effort to ease their concern. Jaquanda Johnson of the Flint Journal reports that the governor's letter notes that he does not want the charges brought against the two DEQ employees to reflect on the conduct of the more than 46,000 other state employees, adding that through their continued good work, the citizens of Michigan can restore their trust in government. A union representative, however, decried the letter, saying that there is a culture of fear and intimidation in the state government right now that discourages people from coming forward out of concern that they themselves would be targeted. UAW Local 6000 representative and legislative liaison Ray Holman added that with this concern, people are becoming paranoid and making less than ideal decisions for fear of losing their jobs. However, Ari Adler, Snyder's spokesman, reiterated what the governor said in his State of the State address in that Snyder encourages and expects employees who see something happening that needs to be addressed to raise that issue without fear of any personal consequence. A bill being considered in Lansing, called by some representatives as a common-sense legislation, would force authorities to inform residents of lead contaminants within 2 days after it is found. Emily Lawler on MLive.com reports that water contaminants are broken up into multiple tiers of urgency. Tier 1 contaminants include E. coli and other things that could immediately sicken consumers, require authorities to inform residents within 1 day. Tier 2 contaminants, which include arsenic and lead, allow 30 days for authorities to notify residents. Under the legislation proposed by Sheldon Neely of Flint, that time frame would be shortened to 2 days. However, with the focus on the Flint water crisis, legislators say that any contaminants discovered now would be disclosed well within the current time frame. The Michigan Court of Appeals ruled this week that a man arrested for driving drunk in his own driveway cannot be prosecuted for operating a vehicle while intoxicated. Khalil Al-Hajjal on MLive.com reports that in May 2014, police were called to a Northville home multiple times over a noise complaint, and on the third visit from police, a man was arrested while he was walking back to his house after sitting in his car listening to music. The court found that the Northville man was not operating his vehicle in an area generally accessible to motor vehicles, and police admitted that his car never left his driveway. Judge Kathleen Jansen dissented, however, saying that there was no moat keeping neighbors from crossing near his vehicle, and the man was still a danger even on his own property. And finally, a judge has thrown out evidence collected without a proper warrant by the FBI. Vice.com reports that the FBI has compromised the Tor network, a computer network that is designed to help users, like whistleblowers and people under the weight of an oppressive regime, to stay anonymous online. The FBI used a single warrant to identify thousands of people around the world and subsequently make hundreds of arrests. However, Judge William Young out of Massachusetts ruled that the warrant used was issued without jurisdiction and thus was void, adding that it follows that the resulting searches were conducted as though there were no warrant at all. Justice Department spokesman Peter Carr said in a statement that they are disappointed with the court's decision and are reviewing options, adding that the government supports the clarification of the rules currently pending in the Supreme Court to ensure that people using anonymization technologies are able to be identified and apprehended if necessary. For more information about today's stories, visit WKUF.FM. I'm David Jackson.